I'm Alan. In today's video, we continue from last week where we set our compound slide to 8 degrees exactly by using trigonometry. Today, I set up my grinding wheel in the tool post and go through the stages of grinding the bore to give us the 8 degrees. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. I've just set the lever indicator up to check the taper in the bore. Now that's reading 0.1 millimeter, which is around 1/4 hour. And I think what I'll do is try and set my grinding wheel up to follow what I've already set up. We'll see how we can grind that taper. This is a simple bracket I made years ago for my rotor zip. Just two pieces of aluminium angle bolted to this part, which has a slot in it, and this can be tightened up or slackened to close the on the rotor zip, which is held in here. That just goes into my tool post. I'll set the tool post square to the compound slide, so that's why it's at an angle. We set at a 8 degree angle, which is a follow up from the video that I did last week, and the rotor zip will fit in here. This is the rotor zip. It has a small collet on the end. You can have two speeds set in,
20 and 30,000 RPM.
It's 240 volt. So that fits in there. Tighten up this nut. And I leave this power switch at the top there, so I've got easy access to switch it on and off. Just hold it in, tighten this up. Okay, so the next job is to put the grinding wheel in. This is the grinding wheel, so it's a mounted wheel. This wheel needs dressing because it's glazed. You can see it's got like a shiny surface on it. That means that all the surface has been flattened by the grinding and there's no rough grit on there. So it's doing more rubbing than grinding. I'll just tighten this up. I've tightened that up. There's a lock on this. You can hear it there. There's a button there you press in and it locks the spindle. And that's ready for the wheel to be dressed. Now for dressing the wheel, I use a diamond, which looks like this, just a piece of steel. And in the end is an industrial diamond. The easiest way I've found of dressing the wheel, just hold it in the chuck, put the diamond through the chuck, needs to extend beyond the chuck, just tighten the chuck, and select a back gear. So now there's less chance of that chuck moving. I can turn it round. What I will need to do now is just bring the rotor zip up higher in the tool post. So that the diamond is on centre line. Ready for dressing the wheel. Now what I have here, this is a vacuum hose. The rotor zip rotates this way. So as I dress, the grit is going to come up into the vacuum, I hope. Bit of safety first. These mounted wheels, all they are is an abrasive that's been bonded to a steel shaft. So when you first use these for the first time, you can see this one, it's so far running out, it will need dressing. Now the first time I've used this one before, so I know it's a safe wheel. The first time you switch it on, stand to one side, because you don't know whether there are any cracks or any defects in this mounted wheel. So anything that goes wrong, this will shatter, the bits will fly out, and if you're standing where you'd normally stand to turn a bar, you'll get that in your face. Also, safety goggles and even a mask if you're doing a lot of dressing. I'm going to turn the vacuum on in a minute. The lathe is not used at all. All I'm doing is holding this diamond. I'll be using my compound slide to give me the correct angle, because that's the way I want to use it when it's on the job, and we'll just dress this face. So I'll turn the vacuum on first. There's some suction. Now we'll turn the wheel on. Now you can see the wheel is dressed, and it's at the same, it's parallel to the angle that I'm going to use it. So I don't need the chuck anymore, I don't need the diamond, so I can take these out. And I'll change the chuck now and put the ER32 collet holder in. The reason why I'm cutting on the back of the hole is that I can see easier what's going on inside. If I was to cut on the front, I can't see. So the lathe is travelling the normal direction. I've slowed the speed down, in this case it's 40 revs per minute. And I'll be cutting on the back of the bore. I've made sure that the grinding wheel is now on centre height, tool height. So it should be cutting along here, and I'll be using the compound slide, which we set at 8 degrees in the last video, to do the grinding. So the first thing I need to do is check that the wheel will go into the full depth of the hole. Is about there. Now I'm going to put the wheel inside to start it, and then I will start the lathe and put the feed on. So I'll move the camera to a better position. Turn the grinding wheel on.
you can see the type of finish you'll get. It all depends on the grit on the wheel that you're using and how fast you move the wheel in and out. But the finish is reasonable for the part. I'm happy with that. You can see there, it's rubbing in the middle. Middle on this one, middle again on that one. Just put that in the collet. Can't remember what it was last time when I tried it. 2 or 3 thou, I think it was. So I'm not going to grind any more out, so I'll change my grinder now to the dial indicator. Run out on that is about just under 2 thou. And I know the bore's running true because I've just ground it and I've not moved it. So obviously that's the collet. Look inside the bore, you can see I've ground right the way down to the bottom. Well, there we are, grinding in the lathe. Easy way to correct some run out or adjust the taper slightly. It doesn't remove much material and it gives a good finish. Well, that's it for the day. Hope that was useful. Hope it was interesting. Look after yourself and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.